Dr. Avinash Nayak. In this small video, I am going to talk about the academic significance of assignments. As we know, every education system survives on a sound and foolproof assessment and evaluation system. A sound and foolproof evaluation system provides quality education to the learners. In open and distance learning system, we have a self-assessment system. This is done through the self-assessment questions in the self-learning materials and through the assignments. So we see that assignments are a compulsory part of every course or program that the learners undertake in open and distance learning system. These assignments, they are compulsory and they are also useful to the learners in formative evaluation or continuous evaluation of the learners is done through the assignments. These assignments, they help the learners grow into independent learners, self-reliant learners, autonomous learners in course of their study during the program or the course which they undertake in the university. These assignments can be of two types. They can be tutor-marked assignments or they can be computer-marked assignments. The tutor-marked assignments, as the name suggests, they are the assignments which are written by the learners and are marked or evaluated by the teachers. While evaluating the assignment responses, the teachers give their feedback and comment on the assignment responses. That provides a feedback to the learners on their performance. So, this is a kind of two-way communication between the learners and the teachers. On the other hand, the computer-marked assignments, they are marked by or evaluated by the optical mark readers. And they mostly consist of objective questions and multiple choice questions. Assignments demand a strong grasp or understanding of the contents on the part of both the learners and the teachers. If the learners don't understand the contents of the self-learning materials properly, they cannot write the assignment responses properly. Similarly, the teachers should also have a very strong understanding of the contents of the self-learning materials in order to evaluate the assignments objectively and properly. Okay? There is a constant interaction between the learners and the teachers in the preparation of the assignments, always. It is there before the preparation of the assignments. The learners seek guidance from the teachers before they prepare the assignments. They also consult the teachers while preparing the assignments. And after they have prepared the assignments, they submit it to the teachers. They also then seek feedback from the teachers on their performance. So it is a great responsibility on the part of the teachers to use the assignments as a teaching tool so that they can really help the learners grow into independent, self-reliant and autonomous learners. The teachers can do this by doing a couple of things. First of all, what the assignment exactly expects from the learners, whether the learners have done it properly or not. And while doing this, they can prepare an assessor's ideal response. And they must use this AIR, assessor's ideal response, as the standard while evaluating the responses of the learners. Then they must discover the deficiencies of the assignment, whether the assignments have been properly planned or not. If the assignments are not properly planned, teachers should compensate that when they evaluate the assignment responses. Then, while checking the assignments, they should see whether the assignments are logically arranged or not, whether there is a beginning, there is a middle, there is an end of an assignment or not, whether the language is properly used or not, whether the presentation is properly given or not. And most importantly, whatever grades, whatever marks they give to the learners, they should really reflect the performance of the learners. If the performance of the learners is not properly reflected, if the teachers become partial while evaluating the learners and giving them feedback, then the learners will be demotivated. So on the whole, we can say that the assignments are a very good tool of teaching and learning. It is through the assignment responses that the teachers can also get feedback on their performance as teachers. They can also get feedback on the course on which the assignments have been designed. They can also get feedback on the education system that the university provides in open and distance learning system. Thank you very much.